here in the pits at the NHRA Pep Boys Nationals, Maple Grove, Pennsylvania. The return of a Camping World Series champ, Tanner Gray, back in pro stock for one race. You got the call to drive Derek Kramer's car. Tell me about that phone call and coming back to the NHRA.
Yeah, so I was actually on my way up to Bristol for the truck race and going through the mountains and missed a call from Dave. And then got a text from Cody Anderson, Greg's son, shortly after that asking if I wanted to drive. So I instantly called Dave back and just to kind of see what was going on. And, you know, luckily it worked out logistically for me to come out and get out here on time. So kind of perfect timing for it all. But, yeah, unfortunately, Derek has COVID. So just trying to fill in for him. And hopefully we can do a good enough job to get him some points and, you know, give him a good shot for the championship.
Well, their car has really come around, and I know Derek was going to be super excited to come out here and race in the playoffs after the points reset, and then to get COVID and just the deflating feeling that must be, but to know that he's got someone who's willing to step in and step up and take on the responsibility, that says a lot about the relationship that is happening out here in pro stock and amongst you guys as racers.
Yeah, I think NHRA in general is a really cool family atmosphere, so you know, I'm happy to step in. I don't know how well I'll do. You know, it's been a minute, but yeah, I'm looking forward to it, and I'm excited to go. It's going to be a unique challenge for me. You know, I haven't really been involved in this stuff since I've taken on the truck series stuff, but yeah, hopefully I can get in and not look too dumb.
Right, but you were a champ, and I don't know if it's like riding a bike. It's probably harder than riding a bike, but that muscle memory will come back. But what have you done to make it easier? I have heard that you brought your steering wheel, for instance.
Yeah, I mean, I just tried to get as much stuff that I had in my car when I raced to make myself more comfortable. So, yeah, I brought my insert, my steering wheel, just little stuff. And, you know, we're still, right now, we're trying to get me more comfortable in the car. It's a little bit different than the car that I drove, so still not quite comfortable yet, but we're working on it. So yeah, just got to get everything dialed in the way that, or as close to the way that I like it, and yeah, hopefully make it the transition to get back going a little bit easier.
What were the reactions you got over there? I know the news was broken on the Camping World Series event, and you and your brother were battling it out on the track. They were talking a little bit about you're going to come to Camping World drag racing, but what about some of the other drivers? Oh, man, you're getting pulled back into drag racing for an event.
Yeah, honestly, it was super quiet over there. I didn't tell anybody when I got the phone call. I'm not sure if even all the guys on my team knew that I was going to do it. I didn't realize that people knew about it until someone came to me right before the race and mentioned it. So, yeah, I mean, I think it was kept pretty quiet. Not a lot of people know. And I was trying to keep it that way, to try to stay under the radar, not have too much pressure on me. But, no, I'm excited. Looking forward to it. Hopefully I can have a good weekend for these guys and have some fun while I'm at it.
Well, I am excited to have you back. Past champion, you go out there, you conquer it all, and then go on to NASCAR, and you're fighting your way through that as well, but you'll all be always be a drag racer to us. So, Tanner, welcome back, good luck, and thank you for diving in for the Kramers as well. They've got a lot on the line here in the playoffs. You will be earning points on their behalf, so good luck and thank you.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate it.